Dogs and Cats Does Countdown. Sean Lush, Lee Mack, Catherine Tate, Miles Duck, Dr. John Cooper Clark, Susie Fink, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
And welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, in China, they reckon you need to know about 2,000 Chinese characters to read a newspaper. But sadly, the only Chinese characters I know are Bruce Lee and Jackie Chan. William Shakespeare wrote 37 plays. I love Shakespeare. He's great for people who want a night out of the theatre, but they don't want all the hassle of understanding it or enjoying themselves. And the word snurtle means to suppress a laugh and can be used in phrases such as, every time Jimmy took off his trousers, the girl snurtled. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's special guest team captain Lee Mack.
That's me.
Lee left school at 15 with just two O-levels, and to make matters worse, neither of them were his. At least he met Catherine Tate. One of Catherine's best-loved sketch characters is Nan, a cantankerous, grumpy pensioner who makes everyone feel uncomfortable by saying offensive things. Sean Locke is suing for copyright. Catherine Tate starred as Donna Noble in Doctor Who. Of course, we've all got our favourite doctor. Mine is Dr. Neil Sanderson, the surgeon who gave me my penis extension. Up against him this evening is Sean Locke.
Thank you.
This year, Sean embarks on a UK-wide tour where he'll be visiting Ipswich, London, Dundee and Liverpool. So if you're a detective watching this in 18 months' time, that's the pattern you should be looking for. And joining Sean tonight is Miles Jupp. Miles is so posh that when he was on the Royal Variety Show, the Queen and Prince Philip queued up to shake his hand. OK, Miles, you went to some pretty posh schools, and yet you're the worst player we've ever had on Countdown.
Is that right?
Yes, you're the worst. You've never scored a point on this. You're awful at it.
I've not scored a point. Have I not won any rounds or anything?
Nothing.
Really?
And you've had an education that cost, I mean, thousands.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just a bad advert for it. I'm not saying that, you know, private schooling should be outlawed, but perhaps it should. No, I'm sorry that I've not won it. But maybe tonight I will.
Oh, no, I don't... I wouldn't have thought so.
If you... Have you played this, or have you only ever been in the... Let's not call it the easy chair, but your chair. Have you been a contestant on this ever?
I've never been a contestant. I think it's beneath me, frankly.
But it's...
It's great to have you here, Miles, but frankly, I...
You couldn't play the game, because then who would do your job? Because nobody could do your job.
Maybe some teeth in a glass.
Sean, here's a question for you. If you had three wishes, what would you do?
Well, how many in One Direction now?
There's four members currently in One Direction.
Oh, that'd be pointless. Three wishes. Well, weirdly, Jimmy, I've actually had three wishes and they came true.
What were they?
Well, the thing was, I didn't really take advantage of them at the time because I was hungry, thirsty, and had a bit of a draft on my neck. So, cheese on toast, pint of bitter and a scarf.
Lee, if you were in charge of the country for one day, what would you do?
I'd probably spend the day trying to solve anagrams. Can we get on with it?
Do you think you got a chance this evening, Lee?
A chance? Well, genuinely, while she was talking, she didn't instill me with confidence. She leaned in, lifted her cup up and went, do we get to keep these?
And just the other thing, you know when you're doing the stuff, you know the do 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 do. That's is that happening?
Do you know the do 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 do?
Or is that there to put you?
No, you hear it.
So that's quite off-putting, isn't it? No. I don't know if you're joking or not.
No, yeah, you hear that as you're doing the quiz.
Well, I've got to find letters and stuff.
That's the game, yes. I mean, you've not seen the show.
I have seen the show. I just thought people aren't trying to find letters with all that going on.
Yes, that's the game.
Oh! All right.
I was thinking of the day that... Listen to this.
I mean...
If you work out the law of averages, of the average age of the audience that watches The Real Countdown, statistically, it must have been that somebody once, that was literally the last thing they heard. What an awful way to go. Right on it as well. Da-da-da-da. Boo!
OK, Catherine, old people love Countdown. Do you think your character, do you think Nan would love the show?
She'd go, Countdown. She'd Countdown on it. Lovely. Love a bit of Countdown. Jimmy Carr. It's not Alan Carr. No, Jimmy Carr. Countdown. Well, a load of old shit.
Lee, have you got a mascot?
Yes, Jimmy. I brought my lucky restraining order. This is my restraining order that Susie Dent got against me. But she doesn't realise it expired 2 days ago, so... got to look at it. So, I like the fact that the props department have made me this restraining order with a pink ribbon round it. Like, restraining orders come like a certificate that you've graduated. Tell you that you have to keep 500 metres away from Susie Dent. Filled it in. That is a lot. Restraining order. Lee Mack, full name Susie Dent.
Okay, Catherine, have you got a lucky mascot?
Well, my mascot dates back to, gosh, a long time ago, possibly the last time I worked with you. Lee and I did a show together in Edinburgh at the Edinburgh Festival where no one knew who we were. We used to do a sketch show, and Lee, there was one sketch set in Wimbledon, right? And Lee. Who was
I thought you were still going on about.
Shut up! He used to make me wear this because, you know, people won't understand it's a sketch about tennis. So you've got to wear a cap. You've got to wear a tennis cap.
It's been 18 years. Let it go.
And I used to say, I'm not wearing that cap. And I used to. And anyway, he used to shout at me before we go on.
Yeah.
Put the fucking hat on. Put the fucking hat on.
It's true.
It is true. It's before I was on stage. Oh, God. Put the fucking hat on. Why don't you shut up? Because it's not. And that hat, that hat...
Is that the hat?
That is the hat. They've had to take out the...
Bloodstones.
The bloodstones and the logo, right? This is the hat you used to make me put on. I used to not want to put it on because I look like a right mug in it, right? And why it's lucky for me is, ever since I refused to wear that hat, things worked out well for me.
OK. Miles, have you got a mascot?
I've not been very successful whenever I've been on this particular programme, but I have had some luck in this set of studios. Here we are. I've got... This is something that I actually won successfully in these studios. I don't know if you... How does this make you feel?
Well done, Miles. He's rubbing it in.
I don't mean to be unpleasant, but about...
Did you hear how many claps that got?
That was specifically... for Rachel, because 5 years ago...
Something like that.
Rachel and I appeared on Celebrity Mastermind, and I was victorious.
You were.
What was your specialised subject?
It was about son of Manchester, Mike Atherton. And, Rachel, yours was about Manchester United, wasn't it?
It was Manchester United, yep. I did all right.
Why didn't you do adding up? You'd have been good at that.
What I'm saying is, if I don't win tonight, you can have this.
Oh. Rachel, do you even want that?
No. Not even a
right,
second thought.
Off,
no.
Off withdrawn.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
I do have a mascot, Jimmy. Yeah, here it is.
What's this?
It's my new thing, Jimmy.
Your new thing?
Arranged fruit. Find something that was I could express my creative side, and I could. It was soothing, relaxing. It was something that I went on a course, and I never looked back. As soon as I stepped in there with ghee, it just set me free. It literally just set me free, and he taught me. I mean, the reason I've gone here, I've done one bowl of fruit that I've arranged,
right,
and one. just stay. I think they one of the production team did this.
That looks like a zookeeper's bucket, doesn't it?
It's a disgrace.
But my skills aren't just. Ah, I'm not. I haven't finished yet. My skills aren't just with fruit. Once I realised I had this talent, I found I could do it with biscuits. Literally, I just emptied a tin and just went like that.
And you came up with that?
Yeah, I came up with that.
Wow.
And I can turn it to anything. I do pine cones for a lot of Premiership footballers. But I'm also moving into cheese boards. Look at that. Have you ever seen a better cheese board? It'd be a crime to eat any of that cheese. And a lot of people arrange cheese boards in different ways. Some people do it in the region, some people do it from hard cheese to soft cheeses. I've done my cheese board politically. So we've got some Manchego there. We've got some Comté from France. We've got some Dolce Latte from Italy. We've got some Dutch Gouda there. And from England, we've got some cheddar. It's a cheese-based Brexit joke. That's all that was.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's legendary performance poet Dr. John Cooper Clarke. John says punk will never die, but from the look of him, I'd give it 5 years max. It's lovely to have you on the show. You're a fan of Countdown, right?
Big fan. Chase it round the channels 3 times nightly.
Wonderful.
Now, would you be good at actually playing the game? Are you decent at Countdown?
Oh, I'm shit up.
Now, John, your poems have been on the GCSE syllabus. How do you feel about that? It's very established.
Well, obviously, I'm delighted that my poetry is being rammed down the reluctant throats of school children. Finally, I'm in a position to make people unhappy, and there's nothing they can do about it.
And with John, of course, it's Susie Dent. Earlier this year, Susie attended an event for rescue dogs that needed to be rehomed. While she was there, 20 dogs were put to sleep. But don't worry, as soon as she left, they woke up again. Susie, it's Catherine's first time on the show. Any advice?
Well, this is really exciting for me because I'm not sure I've ever met anybody who's actually got into the dictionary. And Catherine did with Am I Bothered? Bothered is in the dictionary. Forever. Oh, once the word's in, it never goes out. I'm going to have to buy one now.
You can't argue with that.
No.
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel is gluten intolerant. If you're not sure what that means, it means Rachel has to spend the rest of her life trying to avoid people rolling their eyes at her at dinner parties. Rachel, what do you and Susie talk about when you're not on Countdown?
We mostly try to work out why you're so mean to us every week. And what we can do to make you stop.
Well.
And what we can do to make it look like an accident.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for this evening is this, the Countdown Boombox. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Lee and Catherine, you get the first pick of the letters.
Catherine, you've not done this before,
no.
Have you? No. So you
have OK, to do. Yeah, you ask for one
you
or the other.
Consonants or vowels.
I know, shush. Consonants.
No, like, with the hat on.
Shut up. G. Oh, God.
OK, keep going.
Is it all me?
Yeah, you can't just stop at that, otherwise it'd be hard to make it worse.
Vowel.
Please.
Vowel.
O.
Consonant.
H.
Consonant.
C.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
F.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
And the last one,
please.
T.
OK, and your time starts now.
Pretty much.
That's right, fuck off. How many, Lee?
I've got a risky seven.
A risky seven. Catherine, how many?
I've got two fives.
So a ten?
Yeah.
Sean?
I've only got a five.
That's OK. You've got Miles. Don't worry about it. Miles.
I've got a five and I'm absolutely thrilled about it.
Well, let's hear your five. What's your five?
Well, it was inspired by your, I mean, excellent physical work, fight.
So you saw a fight and you just went, fight?
Fight.
Yeah. Fine. Sean, your five?
Well, goes in nicely with Miles's. Tough.
Tough. Tough fight. Catherine?
Chief.
Chief.
Yeah, chief's there. Yeah.
Chief fight, tough.
Is it I before E?
Except after C.
Lee, what was yours?
Well, I've got two dodgy seven-letter ones, and I don't know which one to go for.
The least dodgy of the two.
OK, I'm going to go for Tuffy.
Wow.
Yeah, a person who's tough and determined. Or you might say, that's a toughy, that's a difficult question. Excellent.
Seven very points good. For Lee. Dr. John Cooper Clarke, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
I think seven was tops, as far as we were concerned, but John got toughy within about 5 seconds.
I got it in three. Just saying.
So seven was the
yeah, I think
max.
Seven was tops. Yeah.
I got a confession to make.
Go on.
I actually
don't.
No, okay. I don't know the rules of countdown, so I better not say it.
What?
Not saying it?
No, you can't do that.
Right.
Only if you guarantee that I can keep the points.
You can definitely keep the points. 100% you can keep the points.
If you say I can definitely keep the points, I'll tell you what happened.
Right, yeah, sure.
Not what happened.
My word was coffee, and when you said tough, I thought tough is better. But instead of seven.
OK, so at the end of that, Lee and Catherine are in the lead with a total of 7 points. OK, on to our first numbers round. Sean and Miles, you're to pick the numbers.
Now, this is maths.
OK, can I have two from the thing and four from the other one?
Yeah, two from the top.
OK,
thank
Sean
you.
Sean Classic, four little.
OK, here we
and
go.
And your little ones are 8, 1, another 8, 10, 100,
Catherine,
and
are you
50.
Clear on this bit?
Hold on.
Are make a right? word out of
I
those
was going to say, these look... this is a... These look like strange letters.
OK, so the target is 482.
482.
Your 30 seconds... starts now. OK, the target was 482. Catherine, I was going to ask, have you got it? But 20 seconds in, you turned to me and said, can you only use each number once?
Yeah.
And that tends to suggest you haven't got it.
Yep. Or...
have you?
Exactly. Let's wait and see.
Well, I mean, that's happening now. You yes.
Tell me. Me first? That's not fair. OK. No. No.
Lee, have you got it?
I got 481.
481, okay. Sean?
483.
Okay, and Miles?
483 also.
Okay. Lee, how did you get 481?
So I got 8 times 50.
8 times 50 is 400.
And then 8 times 10.
The other 8 times 10, 80.
And then add the 1.
Yep. One away.
So you got 483, Sean? How did
yes.
you do that?
10 times 50 is 500. 8 plus 8 plus 1 is 17. Take it away, 483.
Yep, one the other way.
7 points to both teams. Rachel, could it be done? 482.
Yeah, 50 take away 1 is 49. Times 8, 392. Plus 100, take away 10.
Time to go across now to Dictionary Corner. John Cooper Clarke, have you got any poems for us?
I have, Jimmy, yeah. Less is often more. And nothing proves this more than the time-honoured haiku word. It's a poem of a 17-syllable discipline, and I've written a few in my time. In fact, I embraced minimalism in 1958, and I realised that material possessions were merely a roadblock on the highway of enlightenment, and this is the first haiku I ever wrote, the one that put me on the road of Zen. Haiku number one. To freeze the moment in 17 syllables is very diffic. One could live a lifetime and never get round to verifying their various lifestyle choices, but I was lucky enough 2 years ago doing the Glastonbury Festival. So was the Dalai Lama, the king of minimalism himself. So I arranged a meeting with him. Well, you know, I was introduced, we shook hands, the whole of my right-hand side sobered up. And that's when I explained to him my lifestyle choice of minimalism. Many years ago, I said, Your Excellency, I realised that, like I've just told you now, material possessions, etc. Put it this way, I've got it down to a George Foreman grill and a bottle of disinfectant. What do you think? And his reply, I've only ever forgotten it once. And he said to me, he said, Jesus, Clark, you want to get some shit. So, true story, you couldn't make it up, literally. And with that in mind, minimalism, it's always been a strong thing in my act. You know, I don't credit people with a gigantic attention span. And I've circumnavigated the globe nine times, reciting limericks all the way. And take it from a professional, it's the people's choice. For instance, two ugly sisters from Fordham took a walk one day out of boredom. On the way back, a sex maniac jumped out of a bush and ignored them. So it's a two-liner, is as minimal as I can get, and it's an unsavoury subject, but somebody's got to deal with it. I call this one necrophilia. Fed up with foreplay and all that palaver. Abacadabra.
John Cooper Clarke, everyone. The scores at the moment, Sean and Miles have 7, Lee and Catherine have 14. And here is your teaser. The words are daily sex, the clue is don't put your D in the wrong place. That's daily sex, don't put your D in the wrong place. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were daily sex, the clue was don't put your D in the wrong place. It was, of course, dyslexia. OK, we've been playing a team so far, but this game is just for Lee and Sean. So it's your turn to choose the letters, Lee.
I'll have a consonant, please.
Thank you, Lee. V.
Vowel.
Oh. I.
Consonant, please.
N.
Vowel.
E.
Have we got enough letters left to spell out Jeremy?
No.
Keep going, keep
consonant.
Going.
G.
Vowel.
G.
Got one.
A.
Come on!
Consonant.
No, vowel. Go vowel.
Consonant.
Yeah!
Four-letter word out of that.
I. A consonant, please.
And the last one.
N. OK, and your time starts now. Can you just... How many?
I'm going to go for a very risky 7.
Me too. 7. Vinegar.
Lee, what was your seven?
Oh, yeah. Vinegar.
OK, you could have had vinegar in. So 7 points to both teams. John Cooper Clarke, Susie Dent, could they have done any better than vinegar?
Yeah, yeah, that's it.
I don't know where Susie's other hand is, but...
we got ravening.
Yeah.
For, ravening?
What does that mean?
It means extremely hungry and hunting for prey. And there's one more, eight.
Go on.
Which is arginine, or arginine, which is a basic amino acid.
Yeah, it's arginine.
Arginine, Susie. Sorry. Arginine.
I thought you couldn't have real names.
It's not a proper noun.
It's my sister's name, Arginine.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Miles have 14, Lee and Catherine have 21. OK, right now it's time for Miles and Catherine to go head-to-head.
Oh, God.
Catherine, your turn to pick the numbers. You've yet to score.
Hmm? What?
You've got to pick the numbers.
Seven.
Seven?
You'd like a seven.
Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying you pick the numbers.
So I'm asking... What?
So we've got four big ones and 20 little ones, and you have to get six. So I can pick any six.
So I go a top one?
Yeah. That's a big
one. How do I know what number that is, though?
I'll turn it round in a second and it'll be a big surprise.
Oh, OK.
Otherwise, it'd be a bit easy.
Hmm? No, because I could say 7, 11, 15, 72 and 3. I wouldn't know what number it was going to make.
Well, that's a fair point.
So why don't you just do it like that, for God's sake?
Do you know what? That's a fair point.
It is.
Two from the top, four from everywhere else.
OK.
Trust me.
Two from the top and four from everywhere else, please.
Well
done. Thank you, Catherine.
Write these numbers down on your pad.
Shut up. No, only use them once.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a bit like certain guests on this show.
Make the numbers up.
No, I only use them once.
Oh, shut up.
Five. Nine.
You've actually write these down.
Sorry,
and
no,
five. And then the big one, 75 and 100. And the target. Oh, Christ.
No, that's fine. Even that's going to be a challenge for these two. Your time starts now.
I'm going to try and make 101 out of those numbers.
OK.
You do have to use them all.
Catherine, did you get it?
Why do you always ask me first? Can you ask Miles first, please?
Sure, Miles, did you get it?
Yeah.
Oh, but mine's... I haven't written anything down, so mine's in my head.
OK, fine, just do it in your head.
All right, 100.
Yeah.
So you're one away.
Oh, is that what you do? You just go... Yes! I'm just gonna... It's 100. And I'm one out.
Miles, how did you do it?
I've got 102. No, what I did, I went to the bother of subtracting four from five. Then I just panicked for 26 seconds. I mean, total panic. And then I added it to the 100.
Oh!
Oh, so it could be done.
Look, I'll be honest, I've never seen this show.
Oh, really?
But I like it.
OK, so Lee and Catherine have 21 points. Sean and Miles just ahead with 24. Another treat for everyone. Time to go across once more to Dictionary Corner. John Cooper Clarke, what have you got for us?
Another poem, Jim.
Fabulous.
Anybody who's ever seen me before will have possibly noticed that I've been piling on the pounds lately. Thanks for not pointing that out. I know how bad it is. I fell downstairs last Monday. The wife thought EastEnders had finished early. Thanks for not pointing this out. But there is a reason for this dramatic weight fluctuation, and it's since I quit using narcotic drugs. So it's very difficult for me here. If I see anybody that I used to know, it's the same old cry. Hey, Dr. Clark, get back on drugs, you fat fuck. What I'm trying to say is they're not being helpful, frankly. Probably I wrote a poem about it, and this one's called Spookily Enough, Get Back on Drugs, You Fat Fuck. When I go back to Longridge Park, does anybody wish me good luck? All they say is, hey, Dr. Clark, get back on drugs, you fat fuck. Get back on drugs, you fat bastard. Get back on drugs, you fat fuck. We only like you when you're plastered. Get back on drugs, you fat fuck. They say I'm piling on the pounds, but that ain't the only reason I suck. Put the donut down and get back on drugs, you fat fuck. Get back on drugs, you fat degenerate. Get back on them, you schmuck. You're the size of a minor emirate. You were good once, but I don't remember it. Get back on drugs, you fat. Jumping Jehoshaphat. Get back on drugs, you fat prick.
Should just say to any children watching, don't do drugs, he's 35.
Can I just tell you this quickly? We went horse racing together, didn't we, John, at Cheltenham?
When he says horse racing, we weren't actually sat astride we were in the jockey club putting bets on.
And he went over to the bookies bit in the corner, and we were in a nice bit with loads of TV screens all round us, and he says, go on, have a bet. He goes, let's have a bet. Comes back, you know, if you remember this, you'd had a few, John. And I said, have you had your bet then? He went, well, I tried. Turns out the arse I want doesn't exist. I said, what do you mean it doesn't exist? He goes, well, you know, all these TV screens around us. Well, I'd heard a tip. Turns out I think I was listening to an advert.
OK, the scores at the moment, Lee and Catherine have 21, Sean and Miles just in the lead with 24. And here is your teaser. The words are feel dung and the clue is I'm covered in it. That's feel dung, I'm covered in it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were feel dung, the clue was I'm covered in it. It was, of course, engulfed. Now, before we go on, a chance to win some bonus points. In honour of John Cooper Clarke being here, I've asked our players to write some poems. They're going to perform them now. John will obviously be the judge, and the winning poem gets 5 bonus points. Oh! John, have you got any performance tips? Obviously, you're brilliant at performing
well,
poetry.
Well, I tell you, a prize like that, I wouldn't want to live in a world where that wasn't worth fighting for. 5 bonus points.
It could be the first points Catherine ever wins.
You never know.
Sean, you are up first with your poem. Do you want to tell us about your poem first?
It's very hard writing poems. I had a go at it. It's a very difficult thing to do. It's easy to start, quite difficult to finish. As John spoke, as a fan of the limerick, I'm a fan, and I've created my own genre of limericks, which is the gritty limerick, which is taking a light-hearted, jaunty medium and addressing some quite powerful social issues. Well, this one deals with, I think, that old society is something that we ignore. It's a pain that's going on in every street, which is the neglect of older people. And this one is, it's quite a beautiful one, quite proud of it. Old Mary from flat 52 died months before anyone knew.
That's fucking heartbreaking.
She pegged out on the bog, was eaten by a dog, and all that was left was a shoe.
John, what do you make of that?
That's a savage indictment. To be honest, though, as the old enemy on the wrist catches up with me and I get older, I wish I was more neglected. I dream about it. It's a kind of dream I have, that people leave me alone.
Miles, can we have your poem?
And can you stop? You're moving around quite a lot.
Shut up. I don't want this degenerating into the sort of shambles we've seen over there. People's emotions coming far too readily to the surface.
You just keep moving, just can't you sit still?
Right.
You fat fuck.
This is for you, John. Not these fucking ball bags. It's absolutely amazing to me performing poetry on Countdown on TV because my meter and scansion and rhyming aren't that great, actually, like my maths.
John, what do you make of that?
It has a certain flinty integrity.
That's what I was after.
Hard to ignore. He's obviously put the hours in.
OK, Catherine, your poem.
This is called Ode to My C-Section Baby. They cut me open to give you life. So bloody well stop crying.
John, what do you think?
I think she's in there early with the guilt trip and admirable. Again, you put the hours in.
My poem is called Old Age Pensioner's Knickers. Roses are red, violets are blue, Ethel's are green.
Probably a bit too long, but you know.
John, any comments there?
I think that's part of a great tradition, and I would have expected nothing less from Mr. Lee Mack.
So who's? I mean, it's a tough decision, but who's the winner?
It's well tough. I mean, I'm going to go Sean.
Well, congratulations. That's 5 points to Sean and Miles.
Yes.
OK, on with the game. Sean and Miles, your turn to choose the letters.
OK, vowel, please.
Thank you, Sean. E.
Consonant, please.
G.
Consonant, please.
D.
Another consonant, please.
T.
Another consonant, please.
P.
Vowel, please.
O.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
S.
I'll have a consonant, please.
The last one. M.
OK, and your time starts... now. Okay. Sean, how many letters?
Six.
Six. Miles?
Five.
Lee?
Five.
Catherine?
Five.
Catherine, what's your five?
Pages.
Okay, pages. Lee, what's yours?
Goats.
Miles, your five?
Goads.
Sean?
Staged.
6 points to Sean. Well done. Wow. John Cooper Clark, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
We got a couple of sevens here. Stamped.
Yeah.
Stamped.
Yeah.
Pomades and dampest.
OK, so the scores at the end of that, Lee and Catherine have 21, Sean and Miles are in the lead with 35. And here is your final teaser. The words are ping tits, the clue is my mum hates me doing this. That's ping tits, my mum hates me doing this. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were ping tits. The clue was my mum hates me doing this. It was, of course, spitting. OK, time for our final letters game. Lee and Catherine, your turn to choose the letters.
I'm getting quite... I'm not joking. Can I have a banana?
Yeah, from the other bowl.
What can I put there?
Just that bowl is perfection. I don't want to ruin something that I've created.
Fine. I'll have a vowel, please.
Thank you, Lee. Oh.
Can I have a consonant?
Ah.
Consonant.
Why?
Consonant.
R.
Right, you take over from here, Catherine.
Vowel.
You.
Please. Consonant. Oh, I've got to write them down as well. a vowel, please.
E.
And two consonants, please.
And B. And the last one. R.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. Bloody gilfs.
Lee, how many?
Five.
Five. Sean, how many?
Five.
Miles, how many?
Six.
Six? Catherine, how many?
I'm not even sure.
Do you want me to count them for you?
I know how many there are. I don't know if it's a real word. Five.
OK, what's your word, Catherine?
Rooney.
Rooney?
No, it's runic. You can have
the runes. That's what I was Rooney. Thinking.
So, Lee, what was your five?
Rerun.
Ooh, is nice. Rerun allowed, Susie?
Rerun?
Yeah.
Absolutely fine.
Sean, what was your five?
Berry.
Sorry, are we interrupting your cheese eating?
I didn't write down the B. I put four R's. No wonder.
Miles, your six?
Reborn.
Mm. Reborn.
Lovely. Very good.
Six points to Miles. Yeah. John, Susie, could they have done any better?
Just sixes.
Sixes, really. Burner.
Yep.
Born.
Born.
With a U. Ornery.
OK. Catherine.
Yes.
I think it's fair to say, I think you've done great on the show considering you've never seen the show.
Yeah.
There's a conundrum bit at the end.
All right.
So just a straight conundrum. So jumbled up letters.
Yes, it's just one word.
Just one word. If you got that word, it would redeem you.
Basically, every time a person comes on, does the show for the first time, they always get the conundrum.
No, they don't.
Always.
No, they don't.
OK, fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's countdown conundrum. Your time starts now.
On the other ones, you go, oh.
Those are the brake bumpers. Those are the ones that we do when there's ad breaks.
Okay.
OK, so I'll restart the clock. But there's no clue.
wait. Thorn. Thoughtfully.
Wealthily. Let's have a look.
Very good.
To consider. I know the rules.
I know what you're going to say.
Spent half of it sticking a banana on a clock. Two, she didn't have a guess. She was checking the rules.
I didn't know you're supposed to get them.
You know what's really funny about sticking the banana on the clock? Mm. Wasn't that fruit bowl? It was this one.
Look at that. That's rubbish.
That's the fruit bowl. And you fell for it. Didn't see it at all.
Oh, God, bloody hell. Lee, you were just out of time, but we'll give you the points. OK, so the final scores are Lee and Catherine have 31 points, Lee doing a lot of the heavy lifting there. But tonight's winners with 41 points are Sean and Miles. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Boombox. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Like, can you remember the series The Hotel? Can you remember manager Mark? Can you remember just how well his management skills were? Well, let's see if they're any better when he takes over on Celebrity Island with Bear Grylls tomorrow at 9. And if you missed our brand new series Dan with Joe Brand on Tuesday night when it started, you can catch up on all four. Next, Johnny Depp stars in the network premiere of Transcendence, a bit like humans gone wrong.